Final instructions from our referee, Yuji Shimada. Both athletes predicted second round wins. Putol says second round submission, rear naked choke or armbar.
Ready,
Sabau says left way will triumph, second round knockout, right hand. And listen to them start to chant here for Sabau and Putol.
Putol looks extremely relaxed inside the cage right now.
Putol believes that Sabau is exploitable on the ground. Says he knows that Sabau is not competent in the ground game. The plan here is to conserve energy, strike with Sabau, take him down when the opportunity presents itself and submit him. Putol says he's not going to rush.
Putol says he wants to kind of lure Sabau into a false sense of security by initially striking with him in these first couple minutes, but then attack that lead leg, grab a single, and get this contest to the ground.
A three-way camp for Putol, a five-way camp for Sabau. And just a filling out process, you can see the massive differential in height and reach, the beanpole that is Putol. Very tall, long, gangly athlete. The shorter, stockier Sabau.
Putol is big for a featherweight at 1.8 centimeters. He is a big guy. He immediately goes in for the takedown.
Pinched those hands behind the knees, drove into the canvas for a double leg takedown. Did Putol.
You can see him trying to circle Sabau away from the cage. Sabau's got to start pushing on that head, work his way back up to his feet.
No fence.
Yep,
no
grabbing fence. The fence there, can't do that no to fence. Get back up to his feet though.
No fence.
Putol looking for another takedown, gets it, will he mount him here? Yes, he does. Sabau may make the cardinal mistake of giving his back. Oh, reversal, how about that? Out of nowhere, that is amazing.
Sabau just relaxed for just a minute, got taken down, but then he was able to reverse it, but again,
and reverses Putol again. What will that do, Mitch? The mental, the psyche of Putol, two times reversed by a man who he said had no ground game.
I don't think it's gonna faze him too much. He seems relaxed and composed, but it's gonna really depend on how Sabau uses this position. Is he able to soften him up with a little bit of ground and pound? You can see Putol trying to grip fight, possibly threatening a triangle there. Got the butterfly hooks in, might be able to sweep him here. Oh, good hips by Sabau.
This sellout raucous crowd in Yangon seems to be firmly behind the left-way star Sabau. Top five ranked in the country. That means in the world of left-way. Throws the legs up, does Putol.
Putol's looking for a submission. He's throwing his legs up like he's attempting something. Sabau's got to be careful. Looks like that triangle is what Putol's hunting for.
Very long legs makes the triangle a potent weapon for Putol. Worked on his wrestling, on his jiu-jitsu, and his submissions in that three-week camp in Putol. Man who speaks very good English, also holds a Bachelor of Science from the University of Dagon. Good elbow across the forehead there from Sabau. Wants to get those hands free. Digs an elbow into the waist of Putol. Staying busy in top position here, Dragon.
You can see him trying to battle that left hand, trying to control it. But Sabau's got a good top game. He's able to control the hips and not let Putol throw up any possible submissions. Putol looks like he's hunting for a sweep. But there's that triangle. Sabau's got to shove that left hand inside, otherwise it's going to be in danger. Good defense, but there comes the armbar.
Armbar from Putol. Can he find it? Can he find it? Sabau defending. Oh, my word. Sabau trying to slam his way out. Oh, this crowd goes bananas. Here comes Sabau. Putol gets caught. This place going crazy. This is crazy. I've never heard anything like it.
Botha's in trouble. He's got to regain his composure. Good a tactic to go for the takedown. He was wobbled there. Sobahu hit him with some big shots.
How about that momentum from Sobahu? Best period of the contest from him so far. And the crowd letting him know it. What a round! What a ripper! This is one championship!
Look at this. Here was that first initial takedown by Phoe Thaw. Look, Sobahu tried to defend, but Phoe Thaw just had the hips, was able to stop it. Here he is on top, able to control a majority of the position. So on a scoring round, the cage control has to go to Phoe Thaw. But look at Sobahu. He was able to get back on top, spend a lot of time on top. And there's that armbar attempt by Phoe Thaw. Picks him up and power bombs his way out of it.
Second round set for three. And this event was sold out weeks ago. There were no tickets left at the door tonight. It was all snapped up. Round two. And here we go, second, after an absolutely epic first. And Sobahu trying to pick up where he left on the return. Close guard here from Phoe Thaw. Sobahu maybe still recovering from that knee.
You've got this jam-packed crowd egging him on, energizing these athletes to continue to fight. Big sweep by Phoe Thaw to end up in the mount position.
Mount position from Phoe Thaw. And Sobahu reversing. Downward elbow to the forehead from Phoe Thaw. Tries to take him to the cage. Elbows again. There's one to the nose. Here come the hands. The crowd are proud from Phoe Thaw.
Oh,
reversal! Reversal! That's unbelievable! That's unbelievable!
How did he do that?
Phoe Thaw said that Sobahu had no ground game. My word, he's been proven wrong.
He has been working on his grappling. To escape some very compromising positions. Sobahu is just using pure heart and strength to power out of these shots.
Wherever you're watching this in 128 countries, it's Hero's Dream from Yangon, Myanmar, and it's amazing. Close guard now from Phoe Thaw. Absolute meltdown inside this stadium. Trying to control the posture of Sobahu. He doesn't want Sobahu dropping elbows, Mitch.
Yeah, he's doing a good job of keeping the head nice and tight, possibly looking for a referee stand-up. Sobahu's got it. Sobahu might want that. He might want to get back up to his feet. And that's exactly what he gets to do.
Here come the news from Phoe Thaw. He tried to take his head off with a high kick.
Trying to get Sobahu to overcommit and lunge forward.
Is it mind games? Is it mind games now from Phoe Thaw, or is it tiredness? Sobahu, calculating, cerebral, gets out of the way of the turning kick. What has Phoe Thaw got left in the
tank. He's not really throwing anything. He's been very cautious in his approach. I'd like to see him put that jab out there for a little bit just to keep Kotov thinking. Not let him get too recovered.
Only got a minute to go here in the second round. How do they keep going here when they're flagging in energy with the fuels running dry, Mitch?
You've got to rely on the crowd. You've got to let this crowd inspire you to greatness. And that's what Kotov's doing. He's digging deep. Battle. Oh, he jumps guard. He jumps guard to the guillotine. Is it deep? Can he adjust?
Can he find the finish? 25 seconds to go in the second round.
Oh, no.
Can Sorbo get free? This place will go bananas if he does.
Don't worry about the legs. He's got to free him off the head and protect the neck.
He may see out the round. He may be too sweaty to get a choke.
Find out. Check out this transition. Kotov had the back, but how did Sabahu get out of it? Brilliant display of grappling by the guy who his opponent didn't think he had any. Look at that, just throwing Kotov out, and then they started to throw. Big knee landed by Kotov. Rocked Sabahu and just barely missed with that head kick ever so slightly.
Let me quote Phoe Thaw from yesterday, because he speaks very good English. He said, "I know what Sorbo doesn't know, and that is the ground game." And I think, Mitch Chilson, that Phoe Thaw may be very shocked by now at what Sorbo has learned on the ground.
This is where you have to dig deep inside of yourself. What does it mean to have that one championship medal wrapped around your neck? How much do you believe in yourself? What kind of strength can you muster from deep inside of yourself? Kotov has never even been out of the first round, Michael. Now he's facing unknown territory. Who's gonna dig deep and get the win here tonight?
A big hello to all of our viewers watching here in Myanmar live on Skynet. Wherever you're watching, in the restaurants, in the bars, at home. They're out of their seats, I'm sure. 128 countries worldwide, potentially over 1 billion people. Nobody does it better in the martial arts world than one championship, and you're seeing why.
Oh,
a big roundhouse kick from Phoe Thaw.
Had to give him some love on that one. Beautifully timed left kick to the side of Sabahu's head, who shook it off, smiled at him, and actually gave him a congratulatory high five.
I tell you what, I would not want to be a judge on this one. It is still anybody's contest for the taking.
Do you think the near submission attempts are going to start to sway in Kotov's favor, or will the top control and reversals of Sabahu be enough? Will they let it go to the judges? Will they let it go that far?
3 minutes 50 remaining. Can someone find a finish? Will we see Sorbo get his momentum going like he is now? He loves the combinations and he makes them sting. He makes them hurt. He makes them count. Kotov throws out a left kick and backs off. Threads the jab, the tall beam pop.
Typical lightweight fighter. He likes to incorporate a vast variety of martial arts techniques. I saw him compete at the World Lightweight Championships, and he was throwing capoeira kicks, Michael. He really has a deep bag of tools to draw upon.
Kotov on the back foot. Jab, two, left hook. Three-punch combination under the jab connected for Kotov. Three-punch combination again. Still under the jab connected.
Swing it in his favor because we do not judge these things round by round. They're judged on in its entirety.
How about that? A little back fist and then turn the knuckles in. Kotov connected. rebound. It has brought the house down many, many times. And we've still got 2 minutes, 10 of it remaining. A fake there from Solbao. What does Phoe Thaw need to do with 2 minutes on the clock, Mitch?
Just that. He needs to throw that jab. Keep the, he's got a 10-centimeter reach advantage. He needs to put that jab out there and let things go. Solbao's got to close the distance and get tight and start to unleash on him.
Phoe Thaw backs off, hands around his waist, breathing through his mouth. That's never a good sign. Uppercuts, looping punches from Phoe Thaw, but Sabahu a little too evasive. Now the little man comes forward, defends against the high right roundhouse. Phoe Thaw throwing all sorts of flurries, wild hooky punches, but they're not landing. He may have guessed himself out again. 1 minute 20 remaining.
Sabahu has constant pressure. He's always moving forward, but Phoe Thaw is being more active. He's throwing more shots and landing, Michael.
Now's the time for Solbao to go to the body. Go to the body while Phoe Thaw is tired.
1 minute left. Has he gone to the body yet? He's only headhunting, Michael. He's only got one weapon. He's throwing those punches at the ever far hand of Phoe Thaw.
Phoe Thaw trying for another spinning back fist. Fires an uppercut. Front kick went higher than Michael Estrom. Solbao moves forward again. Has he got a final flurry? 35 seconds on the clock now. He's calling Phoe Thaw forward.
To the middle of the cage they go. They touch hands. 30 seconds. Let it all hang out, fellas.
They're going to go out on the shield. Amazing scenes here in Yangon, Myanmar. 15 seconds. Watching around the world, how do you score this one? Do you have it for Phoe Thaw? Do you have it for Solbao?
Beautifully timed left high kick. And Phoe Thaw was just more active throughout this entire contest. He had two submission attempts, consistently throwing, just a bit more active in all aspects than Solbao. But we gotta give it to the lightweight martial artist. Solbao, he consistently hung in there, improved his grappling game, continually pushed forward, and had that never say die attitude that we love to see here in ONE Championship.
You see a little bit of the damage there on the face of both athletes. I believe we may have a very close decision here. Solbao on the front foot a whole lot more. But Phoe Thaw had the submission attempts. He came closer about three times. I believe he was shocked, though, by the vastly improved ground game of Solbao. No way that Phoe Thaw saw that coming. And Solbao showing massive respect to Phoe Thaw. Let's find out now from Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Mr. Harry, Director of Sweet and Lwin Media Co. Limited. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of intense battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this bout in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this round in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three scores this bout in favor of your winner by split decision from the